Good morning, everyone. It is Saturday morning around 7 a.m. I'm actually just coming back from an overnight shift. Right now, I worked from 10 p.m. to, it was supposed to be until 8 a.m., but my attending actually let me go a little earlier, around 6:30, so I just got home. It was a great shift. I worked in the non-emergent side of the emergency department. Here, they call it evaluation section, so I was there for a few hours. I did a bunch of really cool, fun things that I love about EM, such as a finger laceration. It was like right at the base of one of the fingers, and I did another laceration repair over like a knuckle. Today was the first day that I actually did everything from start to end, pretty much no supervision, because my attending had seen me do it the first case, and then the second one, he was like, okay, you can just do it on your own. So that was really cool. The patient didn't seem to be in that much pain once everything was numbed up with lidocaine, and everything went great. Also saw a few drunk people, which is typical of Friday night. Saw a case of kidney stones, saw a young boy with like an allergic reaction, and just a few other cool stuff. Yeah, so I'm home now. I'm supposed to sleep because I have another overnight shift tonight. Same location, same section, so hopefully more procedural stuff. I guess if I were to explain a little bit about like the emergent versus like non-emergent stuff, so if anybody comes in who has like really bad vital signs, like they're super tachycardic, if they have like a super high fever, or basically just like the acuity of their illness, so if they seem really sick, then they'll go to the acute side or like the emergent side. If they're young, otherwise healthy, and they have like one like thing that needs to be fixed, whether that's like a, you know, a sprain or a dislocation of like shoulders, or if they have a laceration of their finger or wherever, or if they have like an abscess repair or abscess IND, they'll come to the non-emergent side or the non-acute side. So that's pretty much how things work in the emergency room, at least like the three or four hospitals that I've been to. That's how they kind of triage. Basically, there's a nurse who triages, like the sees a patient when they first come in, and then they kind of determine where they should go. So that's kind of how it works. And like plan for today, I'm definitely gonna try to sleep. It's summertime now, so it's like super bright out already. Hoping to get at least 6 hours, hopefully. I'll be happy with solid 5 if I'm not interrupted, if I don't wake up. It's just hard to kind of sleep in the middle of the day. Today's my first day on nights, hoping for some good quality sleep, and after that I'll probably go work out, eat something, and do whatever, and then I'll head out for my shift later tonight around for the 10 p.m. shift. So I will check back in with you guys later. Okay, Candy's been waiting for me at home. Good morning, guys. It is 1 p.m. So what time did I go to sleep? I think I fell asleep probably around 7:30. So that's like, what, 5.5 hours? I can't do math right now because I'm really tired still. But basically, I think I started to wake up around like noon, and I kept on waking up like intermittently. I think I really need to invest in one of those, like either an eye mask or like one of those like blackout curtains if I, you know, maybe in residency if I have to do a bunch of night shifts, just because I think the light bothers me. Plus Candy was kind of like rubbing up on me, like wanting to like keep me company, and I kept on waking me up. At least I slept, and I think around 2:30 I'm gonna head out to the gym, and honestly I don't really have any other plans. That's the thing about going to work at 10 p.m. You have pretty much the whole day to like do whatever you want, and then you can go to work, but you do have to like stay up at work, obviously. Like usually in other rotations, like for example for OB or for surgery, if there's not much going on, you just kind of go to sleep and then you get paged or you get calls, and then you deal with it then. But for emergency medicine, it's pretty much like you have to be up the whole time because you never know when somebody's gonna come in. And frankly, last night was super busy. There were like 40-50 people in the main part of the emergency room, and at least like 3 to 9 people in the non-emergent side, like pretty much at all times. So, you know, I guess in a city like New York where people don't sleep, people go out and people do this and that, like maybe people are just up more. I don't know if it's like a lot busier in other parts of the country where people might not be staying out so late. But here, people were out and about and like a steady stream into the ED pretty much all night. So that was that. Yeah, so I'm just gonna spend my day. I'm gonna try to vlog, maybe vlog in the gym. I haven't done like a gym footage in a long time. So I will check in with you guys later. So I got pretty hungry when I woke up, so I kind of put together whatever I had in the fridge, to be honest. So here is the leftover cauliflower from yesterday when I roasted it. I actually fried it in my air fryer. This air fryer is amazing. So I roasted the whole head of cauliflower, and my boyfriend came and ate most of it, but there's some leftovers here. And this is chicken. I actually always have this on hand just because it's so convenient and you never know when you're gonna just want some grilled chicken breast strips. So I keep these in the fridge almost always. Some avocado, and these are very special. They're actually kimchi pancakes that my mom made. And when I went to Korea not too long ago, she made a whole batch of them, and then we froze it, and then I brought it back with me. So I also heat these up in the air fryer, and they just come out perfect, and they're so good. So it's kind of a random plate, but it's what I'm gonna eat for today. I know a lot of you guys are asking me about like meal prep questions and my tricks and whatever, but to be honest, I don't always have like super healthy food on hand like all the time. It can be kind of hard to stay on top of grocery shopping and having healthy food on hand, so I kind of make do. I do the best I can. I meal prep when I can, and sometimes I just throw together whatever I have in the fridge like today. Since I am working overnight and my sleep is all weird, I am trying to drink lots of water. In general, I try to drink lots of water. This is my favorite way to drink water. It's just regular water with slices of lemon and these ginger slices. I don't know if you guys can see. It's like the best way to drink water. So there you have it. I am off to gym. I feel like I look asleep right now. I'm pretty tired. I got my Monster and I'm gonna walk over to the gym. See you guys there. About 9:20, I'm headed off to my shift. We just watched this crazy documentary called Mommy Dead Dearest. It's on HBO Go. It's about a case of Munchausen by proxy. Super interesting and very weird. But I have like 7 minutes left of the documentary, but I have to head out, so I will maybe finish it later. Hey guys, it is now Sunday night. Just checking in, and I'm just gonna close the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys liked the vlog. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.